Hello everybody and good afternoon. Today you find me outside our local garden centre. And we're outside Gordon Rigg's garden centre in Walsden, just up the road from where we live. It's a lovely sunny Saturday afternoon here in West Yorkshire. And every now and again, the owner, Peter Rigg, will display some of his classic cars. See the garden centre across the road with a new farm shop just recently opened. And we stood outside Bottoms Mill shop. Lovely shop downstairs. And upstairs you have a nice big cafe, nice shop to visit. And here's the Jowett Bradford that they have. This has been reconditioned by the owners. Lovely little car, nice colour, I like that as well. Very typical of the 40s, 50s styling with the wheel arches and headlights. Lovely inside. I'll take a quick peek in. Oh, if you could just smell this in here, it smells of leather. It's absolutely fantastic. Gorgeous little old clock display there. Now, when the garden centre opened after a few years, they did actually run a Bradford van. This is not the original, but they did find one to restore. Looking very nice. Another little van. Next to that, they've got the Morris Thousand van. These were extremely popular. You'll all remember these from the 60s and the 70s. I think they finished production in 71, as I recall. Lovely, lovely restored van. I remember these as a kid. Absolutely fantastic. And the sound of them were very distinct as well when you let off the accelerator. Lovely van. Little bit of trivia in the window there about the driving test. You'll be able to stop and start that and have a read of it if you like. Attached this in the window on this Morris van of 03. And this is a 1961 version. The early type. Lovely, lovely van. And then at the side of this we've got an Austin Special. I think this is about 1910 as I recall. Or 1930 this one. Austin 7 KC Austin Special. Very basic inside. Marvellous things. Imagine driving these around. Nice wood dash bar with simple clocks in it. This is a lovely shape, it's like a boat at the back. That little curve there at the back, absolutely gorgeous. Then next to it, I believe this one's not been restored. This is in its original as found condition. I must admit, it's very, very good. So the paint's patinaed and cracked. Picking that up. Absolutely lovely. This would have had a rag top. Same again inside, all very basic. Attached this there from 1993. Luminec. £60 to insure it for 12 months in 93. I wish it were like that now. Nice little clock display. Lovely little car. I like these headlights and the way they put onto these rings. It look absolutely fantastic. He has a few more of these, but like I say, he just gets a few out at a time. And this is a Marendaz Special. Now this car was owned by Sir Stirling Moss as mother-in-law back in the day, and she used to do hill climbing in it and one thing and another. Absolutely love this car. I think this is one of the favourites of mine that he has. Lovely, lovely. Look at this bodywork. Wood frame, covered in leather. Very nice. Yeah. Look at that gear stick. How novel's that? Lovely dashboard. Very basic, but just enough to do what you had to do with it. Fantastic, fantastic car. Lovely leather seats in it, well patinaed. This is also, on the back here, this is a storage box, so it's a boot. Yeah, got a locking cap there for fuel. absolutely marvellous bits of engineering. Absolutely love it. I believe this has got a V6 in it. Look at them headlights with the wire mesh on the front, absolutely superb. Marendaz special, fantastic. And then here we've got a Lagonda. Now this Lagonda, these kind of predate Aston Martin, because what happened with Aston Martin was you had Wilbur Gunn, an American who came over to England, and I believe he lived in Staines in Essex, and he started producing the Lagonda, and then eventually it was bought out by Browns and it became Aston Martin. This is obviously a lovely, lovely car. Wooden steering wheel. Gear stick and handbrake down to the right here. Rev counter. Speedo says 120 and I bet it's probably been pretty close in its day. Nice wooden dashboard, that's a gorgeous, gorgeous car. Big fancy chrome headlights on the front. Look at that, isn't that just beautiful? Yeah. And these cars are all maintained and they're all in working condition, etc. Now look at that for an engine, how beautiful is that? Absolutely gorgeous. Spare set of spark plugs. Two carburettors. That is a fantastic looking car. The Lagonda. They still make Lagondas nowadays. But obviously, not in vast numbers, as you would see them everywhere. And then over here is a 1912 Caddilac. Yep, right on drive. This one's just been imported recently from Australia. Fully restored, absolutely beautiful condition. And it also does have a rag top on it. Now when this is parked in the garage, it don't fit in the garage. It only just fits in like it is, and then the top's put up when it's in the garage. But that is a beautiful, beautiful car. Have a look inside it. Look at these clocks down here. Big wood dashboard. These seats are like big leather settees, look, that you'd have in your living room. There's a maker's plaque around the front. It's got the big chrome headlights on the front. How beautiful is that? Now look at this temperature gauge on the top of the radiator. How cars have come on these days. That is absolutely fantastic, stunning example of a Caddilac. We've got a plaque in here, Caddilac motor cars. Absolutely gorgeous. Brake and clutch pedal down there. And the accelerators and the phantom retards on the steering wheel, as these vehicles were. Big old fancy box on the back there. And you see down there, Caddilac hit call. Absolutely stunning car. So I just thought I'd show you these while they're about. It's not often that they are out, but when they are, it's good to catch them on video, one thing or another. So there we are, outside Gordon Rigg's Garden Centre in Walsden. Hope you've enjoyed the video.